Talk for the room in here today, which is going to be about snack package support in GNOME by Robert. So give him a hand.
Hi, so my name is Robert Ansel. I work on the Ubuntu desktop team, and I've been spending about the last year or so getting some snap support into GNOME with a bunch of other people at Canonical. So I just wanted to do this talk to kind of give kind of an overview of what parts of GNOME have Snap support and how we're shipping GNOME with Snaps. So to start off with, if you guys don't know what a Snap is, I pulled this from the Snapcraft website. They are containerized software packages, similar system to Flatpak. It's that sort of generation of packaging system. One of the differences is they come from an IoT background, or embedded, if you're old-fashioned like me, that's what you used to call it. So I started working embedded Linux on industrial hardware, and I can see this is a real, there's real issues there about maintaining software, and I can see where Snaps help out. So in the IoT space, an example would be Screenly. There's a company that makes little Raspberry Pi based digital signage, and they run them using a Snap based system. And Thingbox is the new one that's come out, which is a little device that sits on your network, tells you how fast it is and security issues, stuff like that. And then in desktops, which is where I work now, things like Firefox, Spotify, and Skype provide snaps. So they come out of those projects. We don't build those for them anymore. And that gets it to our users in Ubuntu via snaps. So one of the main places I've spent a lot of time on is GNOME Software. So we've had a snap plugin in upstream GNOME Software since 3.22. That worked pretty well. We worked pretty well with Richard to work out the balance of how we can get coexist with the other plugins like Flatpak and the other systems in there and traditional packaging. Great thing about we found out is that we know users use software a lot. So when we look at the stats on the Snap server, we see, so we thought, well, I don't know how many people actually go to the home screen and like load stuff. If we get a snap and we promote it in that promoted banner, you get a massive uptick in snap downloads, which is great. So it's really helped us within Canonical to say, look, you know, GNOME Software is a really important part of our desktop offering. And we've been working on, with upstreams, with Alan and people like Alan and Richard, ways we can enhance GNOME Software in ways that will make that experience even better. And that should help all users of GNOME and all different packaging systems. So one of the things I wrote is Snappy Glib, and that's a library that wraps up all the Snap interactions into a GNOME-based way. So because Snap is designed for embedded systems, it doesn't use dbus, and it has very light requirements, but you know, nobody wants to have to write custom interaction stuff with all that. So it wraps it up with GObject and async calls, introspectable, so you can run Python and JavaScript stuff that accesses Snap, Bala bindings, bunch of integration tests, 371 at the last count, so it's all heavily tested. It's on GitHub. The next thing we've been doing is James in particular has been working on portal support for snaps. So this is so you can access files and things from your snaps in a safe manner. The same with Flatpak and other systems can. That support has been upstream in XQG desktop portal since 0.11. That's been going really well. It's been working well together with that. And we're shipping from 1804. We've been shipping snaps. So these four GNOME apps, calculator, characters, logs, and system monitor, all a bunch of users of 1804 are getting those via snaps. And hopefully they don't notice any difference. They're just like normal GNOME apps. And then we provide those using the GNOME 3.26 what's called a platform snap, which is the same, similar to a Flatpak, runtime, and so we're shipping that, and that's something we want to increase. I mean, ultimately we want to see everything shipped with new systems like this. That's it, it's kind of short, but any questions? So you mentioned that the Mozilla are shipping Firefox as a snap and Spotify and so on. What was, in particular, these are companies who are not shipping their software as Flatpak or any other kind of desktop, cross distro desktop kind of anything. What did you have any feedback from them about what it was about snaps that made them sort of made it appealing to them?
Yeah, so I didn't work directly with them. We have an advocacy team who reached out to them, but I believe they say things like, you know, really easy, they just integrate into the CI system to spit them out, and they work well. They don't have issues with dependencies, and yeah, so we've certainly helped a lot of them early on to show them how to get going, but most of them seem to take it up themselves. And
so I think some of the features of Snap that Mozilla was particularly interested in was our tracks and channels. So by default in the Snap Store, every Snap can have risk levels of like stable, beta, candidate, and edge. But we can also create tracks for what they were particularly interested in was creating an ESR track. So every certain number of releases, Firefox has an ESR, their stable release branch, basically. And they continue to push updates to that ESR branch. So they want users to be able to track the ESR if they chose to. So like within some organizations, they can say they only want to update for ESR versions. So Mozilla is not only building their own binaries, the same binaries that go through their QA, they're injecting those binaries right into the Snap. So their CI process is building the binaries and putting them into the Snap as well. In that process, they're also doing it for the ESR releases as well, and those are available in the Snap Store. So any user can switch to that track, and they'll only get updates from that track. And that track also has all those same risk levels. So there's beta version they can try out, candidate for their QA. And they seem to be very happy with the process. They've been building the Snap as part of their CI now for well over a year. They just recently kind of announced it and wanted to start using it and published it on their website and stuff. But they've been doing it for well over a year.
Just a little question. The ports for Snap are, does it use SE Linux or AppArmor?
So Snapd uses AppArmor.
AppArmor in Snaps?
Yeah.
The ports, yeah.
I believe one of the features coming is you can layer security systems now, or it's coming with the kernel, and that's going to make it easier for the systems to make use of.
Portals are now available in Snaps, which is also great to see. I know it's probably early on for portals and Snaps, but are there any capabilities or portals that you think that Snap users are missing or that should be added and improved potential?
James might be better to answer that one. The question was if there's any portals that we need that don't exist currently.
I don't think there's any particularly Snap-specific portal which we needed separate from what's Flatpak's got. We're still working on getting a few of the features which exist in XGD desktop portal working with Snaps. I mean, we've got the most important one, which is the file open, file save. I think the screenshot stuff works by default. Got to put in a bit more effort to get like the notifications stuff working. But yeah. I think we want to do all the portal work we're doing. We want to cooperate with upstream. It's like we don't want to be in a position where if you want to run Snaps on a non-Ubuntu system, you need to get an Ubuntu-specific XGD desktop portal. We'd like it so that the XGD desktop portal, which everyone else is shipping by default, supports Snaps if you install Snapd.
So one of the challenges in Snap is because it goes all the way down to IoT. Is other systems for permissions that don't really make a lot of sense on desktop. So we expect that all the desktop type apps will use portals, and that'll be great, and it'll work. And then the more advanced stuff will be more confined to embedded things.
clarification. I was just I was mostly interested in, because you obviously have a great developer reach out and marketing, and some developers who were using Snap who haven't necessarily been using Flatpak or other stuff, so there may be some new requirements that come in. So more than awesome.
Any other questions? I don't think so. Thank you.